Hi, I'm Shalir. This is the third video in the series on Istio. Links to the other video are below. And so for this video, I'll be going over the performance testing that we've done with the Istio add-on. So first, let's talk about the control plane performance. So the control plane is also known as IstioD. And so IstioD configures the sidecars based on all the deployments and CRG configurations, as well as the current state of the Kubernetes system. So its resource consumption will be affected by these three things: the rate of deployment, the number of sidecars connected, and the rate of configuration changes. And of these three, we've so far tested the first two cases. So for testing, we wanted to see the maximum number of sidecars IstioD can manage before it crashes. And this is what we'll be referring to as the sidecar capacity. And we wanted to see how that's impacted by the number of services in the mesh, as well as the sidecar churning. And what I mean by sidecar churning is, let's say we have 50% churn. That would mean that 50% of the sidecars are deleted and 50% of the sidecars are added back. More concretely, is if let's say we have 1,000 pods with sidecars enabled, then if you have 50% churn, then 500 pods would be deleted and 500 pods would be added back. And so for the test setup, we use the Cluster Loader 2 framework, which is an official Kubernetes scalability framework, and we tested with the ASM 1.19. And so for the IstioD, because we wanted to see the impact on IstioD, we set the replica count to 1 and disabled HPA. And shown here is also the Kubernetes version as well as the node SKU. And we also tested these two scenarios, Azure CNI overlay and Azure CNI overlay with Cilium. And these two are the recommended network plugins for large-scale clusters on AKS. And so here we have the data for the control plane with pod churning. And to decrease the number of variables, we only have one service mapped to all of the pods tested here. So if we look here, for Azure CNI overlay with no churning, we see that the sidecar capacity is 25,000 pods. And then if we look at the bottom table, we'll see that Azure CNI overlay with Cilium with no churn has a sidecar capacity of 30,000. So that's about 5K difference. And we'll note that again, for 25% churn, we'll see that the sidecar capacity difference is 10,000 pods. And likewise for 50% churn, we see the same difference. One thing to note here about the data is that you might notice that IstioD's CPU usage is roughly the same, around 15 to 16 CPU, and that's just because it's capped by the CPU usage of the node SKU. And so next we have the control plane with multiple services. First, we'll see that Azure CNI overlay for one service has a sidecar capacity of 25,000 pods. And then at 1,000 services, we see it decreases to 20,000 pods. And one thing to note is the mapping is 1 to N pods. So for 1,000 services, to get 20,000 sidecars would be that each service has 20 pods each. And then if we look at Azure CNI overlay with Cilium, with one service, the sidecar capacity is 30,000 pods. And for 1,000 services, the sidecar capacity decreases to 20,000 pods. One thing to note here is that IstioD's memory usage here actually increases despite having a lower sidecar capacity at 1,000 services. And that's just because there's more services in the mesh, so IstioD's memory usage goes higher. So with that, we can move on to the data plane performance. And here are a bunch of factors that affect the data plane's performance. And so we analyzed the latency and the proxy's resource consumption as a function of some of these factors. So Istio has a benchmarking repo that's open source, and we've modified it for usage with the AKS Istio add-on. And so Fortio is used for load generation. And we tested with revision 1.19, and the Kubernetes version and Node SKU are shown here. One thing to note that's different for this test as compared to the control plane is that we don't disable HPA and we don't change the default count on Istio's replica count. And this is to simulate what the user experience would be like here. And so for the test itself, we have two Fortio pods, the client and server, and the protocol we use is HTTP 1.1. MTLS is enabled and we have a 1 kilobyte payload. And again, we tested with the same two CNI scenarios, Azure CNI Overlay and Azure CNI Overlay with Cilium. And so we measured the sidecar's resource consumption, which at 16 client connections at 1000 QPS. And so we saw that for Azure, for both the CNI scenarios, they're relatively similar resource consumptions where the CPU is 0.4 CPUs and the memory consumption is 72 megabytes. And then we also measured the latency. There's a lot to see here, so I'll be highlighting some notable parts about the graph. I use green boxes for Azure CNI Overlay and purple for Azure CNI Overlay with Cilium. But before I dive into that, the x-axis shows the number of client connections and the y-axis shows the latency in milliseconds. And all of the tests were ran at 1,000 queries per second. And with that, let's take a look at the bottom two graphs. This shows the P90 latencies. And first, let's look at the baseline. And that means that the traffic is not going through the sidecars. And we'll see here that for essentially all of the box plots here, they're all below 0.5 milliseconds, and they're relatively similar across both CNI scenarios. And if we look at the P99 latencies for the baseline, we'll see that the 50th percentile is around 0.5 milliseconds. And we'll notice here at higher client connections from 16 onwards, we'll see that for Azure CNI Overlay, the variation is higher where the user might experience a higher latency closer to 0.75 milliseconds. Whereas for Overlay Cilium, the variation is lower. So that would mean that the latency is more consistent across runs. And with that, let's see the impact of traffic going through the sidecars. Again, let's look at the P90 latency here. We see that the 50th percentile is roughly 0.75 milliseconds for across all of the runs and numbers of connections. And we'll also note that the variations for the sidecar and for traffic going through the sidecar is higher than when it wasn't going through the sidecar. But otherwise, between the two CNI scenarios, they're relatively similar. And then if we take a look here at the P99 latency, we see that the 50th percentile across both scenarios is around 1.75 milliseconds. And we'll note that for Azure Overlay, that the variation compared to Overlay Cilium is smaller. So that means that the latency across the runs are more consistent with one another. And for Overlay Cilium, we'll see that though it has a higher variation, the user actually might occasionally experience lower latency, sometimes as low as 1.2 milliseconds for 4 client connections. And even at 64 client connections, they might experience 1.4 milliseconds. And with that, that's all I wanted to highlight on the latency graphs, and this also wraps up all the data that we've gathered on the add-on's performance. Thanks for watching.